time we stand before a beautiful beach, its waves calm us down. Of course, we can generate electricity from these waves. However, I'm not going to talk about that in this video. Instead, we are going to deep dive to see the amazing ways to generate electricity from tides using tidal barrage. Hi, I'm Vanilla and you're watching The Learning Curve. We all know that sea level is not constant. Sometimes it rises and sometimes it falls. This phenomenon that makes the water either go up or down is known as the tide. The incoming tide is called the flood tide, and when it reaches its highest level, it is called the high tide. The outgoing tide is called the ebb tide, and when it reaches its lowest level, it is called the low tide. In this tidal cycle, we get a high tide followed by the low tide, which is followed by the high tide and again a low tide. This cycle repeats continuously. We get two high tides and two low tides in 24 hours and 50 minutes. Most shorelines experience this cycle. However, some areas have just one of each. You might have noticed that not all coastlines experience the same tidal range. The reason is that the coastline's physical features affect the height of the tides. Tidal range means the height difference between the high tide and the low tide. Some coastlines experience negligible tides, while some others experience a very high tidal range. We cannot generate electricity with a very low tidal range. There are many methods to capture energy from the tides, and one of them is tidal barrage. Generally, power plants will have a turbine coupled with a generator. When the turbine spins, the generator generates electricity. The same technique is used here. We have to trap the water and allow it to pass through the turbine. To do that, we need to build a structure that holds back the water. So basically, we are building a dam inside the ocean. Look at this wide bay. To trap the water, we need to enclose a large area. Building any structure inside the ocean is not an easy process and it is very expensive. Therefore, instead of building a lengthy dam, we need to find a location that requires a smaller construction. In most cases, the dam is constructed in the estuary of the river. We know that all rivers eventually end up flowing into the ocean. The place where the rivers meet the ocean is called the estuary. The Lawrence Tidal Power Station in France is the world's first tidal power station. This power plant uses the estuary of the Rance River. This is the location where the dam is constructed. It is 750 meters long. Now, you may understand that not all coastlines are eligible for the construction of this tidal barrage. It must have a high tidal range and a narrow bay. This region is called the basin. The turbine is placed in the dam. It also has gates named sluice gates that allow the water to go into the basin during the flood tide and out during the ebb tide. Let's first see how to generate electricity during the ebb tide. During the flood tide, let's lock the turbine so that no water enters the turbine. And let's keep the sluice gates open so that the water comes in through it. Now the basin water level is also rising. We should close the sluice gates when these levels become equal, because we don't want the water to leave through the sluice gate. Instead, we want the water to flow out through the turbines. But remember, the turbine is locked now. So the water level in the basin remains constant. It is not completely constant. It's actually slightly increasing as the water is continuously coming from the river. But the sea level is decreasing because it is now in the ebb tide phase. One more thing to consider is if we need a high electrical power, we need a high head. Head is the change in water levels. The more head we have, the more power we can generate. So we have to keep this turbine locked until we have a sufficient head to generate electricity. At that time, the turbine is unlocked. As the water flows through the turbine, it spins and the generator generates electricity. Now the basin water level is also decreasing. The electricity is generated until we have sufficient head. When the head becomes insufficient, the turbine should be locked and the sluice gates are open so that the water can come in through it. This cycle repeats continuously. This method of generating electricity is called the single basin one-way tidal power plant. Because in this method we have one basin and we are generating electricity only during the ebb tide. One of the disadvantages of this method is we are not generating electricity continuously. There are periods when the electricity generation is literally zero. If we need to generate electricity during ebb tide and the flood tide, we need a two-way turbine. Here, the turbine is unlocked during both flood tide and ebb tide. However, it is locked when we have insufficient head to generate electricity. Even here, the power generation is not continuous, but the generation period is increased compared with the one-way cycle. Another type of tidal barrage is double basin type. In this type, we have two basin, the upper basin and the lower basin. A one-way turbine is installed in between the basins. The upper basin is filled with water during the flood tide and the lower basin is evacuated during the ebb tide. The water flows from the upper basin to the lower basin through the turbine, thus generating electricity. This flow is controlled in such a way that continuous power is obtained from the plant without waiting for the tidal sequence. However, two basin scheme is very expensive to construct due to the cost of the extra length of the barrage. Even though the tidal barrages disturb the living creatures in the ocean, it produces renewable electricity without releasing carbon dioxide into our atmosphere. The ocean energy is incredible. It helps to generate electricity using its tides, waves and ocean thermal. I do have a video about ocean thermal energy or OTEC over here. I would highly recommend you to watch that. Bye, see you in my next video.